Thank you. So, one of my favorite things about playing the harp and about playing music generally is exploring music of different traditions, and especially different harp traditions. And the Celtic harp tradition is pretty widely known. But this next song comes from a rather obscure harp tradition from southern Italy, the southern Italian folk harp tradition, that's only really known about because of an earthquake. So in the 19th century, there was a pretty bad earthquake in the southern part of Italy, and in this small town called Vigiano, up in the mountains, most of the buildings were either ruined entirely or cracked. And the town didn't have enough money to need to repair the buildings, and it was a pretty devastating situation. So a group of musicians got together and said, let's go around Italy and play music and see if we can raise enough money to repair the buildings in our town. And it was a harp, a violin, percussion, and flute. So almost what we have here, but I much prefer the bass to flute. So no offense to any flutists out there. But those four people went all throughout Italy playing their music. And Italy is very regional, if you're not familiar with it. So every region has its own food, every region has its own music, every region even has its own, or had its own dialect. So it's very particular region to region. So these four went all around playing their own music from their tradition, and it had two results. One, they did succeed in raising enough money to save the town, and two, it made their harp tradition a little bit more known. So this next song is, it's a medley of three different tarantellas. The first one is called Tarantella di Armento. Armento is the town. And then we're gonna pair that with two other traditional Italian tarantellas.
Hello. சரியலந்தாலவே ஒரு நேரவா சரியலந்தாலவே சீனோல வாபராய் சீனோல வாபராய் சீனோல வாபராய் தலமே தசமாஞ்சரா In un giovai al mondo che non fa gallangherà, in un giovai al mondo che non fa gallangherà, in un dada che poi io devo tutta lì, io mi stanno in bordo, in un dada che poi io devo tutta lì, io mi stanno in bordo. Lizzi e lizzi, moccatore a quattro pizzi, lizzi e lizzi, moccatore a quattro pizzi, moccatore a regamato, moccatore a regamato, moccatore a regamato, c'è la mia vassore da. We will lead to such a tangy. We will lead to such a tangy. You don't get out here, Mr. Leader Wonder. You don't get out here, Mr. Leader Wonder. You don't get out here, Mr. Leader Wonder. You don't get out here, Mr. Leader
traditional Italian instrument as well, the tambourine. He actually has a master's in that. And I should also take a moment to introduce the band. This is Fabio Pirotolo. And this is Cammy Silvi. She just got married. Cammy Duncan. And on bass we have Richard Gates. And I also forgot to mention before, if anyone has any questions about the music we're playing or our instruments or us, please ask, because it's always more fun when you ask questions. Yes?
I was wondering what a tarantella is.
You want to take that one?
Purposely avoided talking about
it. No, I'm glad you asked.
Because I'm going to take the rest of the day. No, I just want to make it short. The tarantella is an umbrella term that pretty much includes all the dances and music from the southern part of Italy. Sometimes people include also the middle part of Italy, so Marche region all the way down to Sicily, but it's usually associated to the music from south of Rome all the way to Sicily.
Okay.
And the name Tarantella is debated. Some people think it comes from the city of Taranto, which is in the Apulia region, the part that is closer to Greece. And some other instead associated to the ritualistic part of the Tarantella, which used to be a healing kind of music. During the Middle Ages, first of all, the term Tarantella, you find it anywhere in classical music, up to early music as well. But in the Middle Ages, the Tarantella was one of those music that was part of what they called the dance craze in Europe. People were burst in a dance up to the point where actually dying for exhaustion. But the Tarantella was the only one who had the cure, and the cure was the music. The legend says, or like the people that were affected by this disease, is that the tarantula bites them, inject the poison into their body, the person becomes the tarantula itself. So in order for this person to exorcise the tarantula out of his or her body, they need to frantically dance to the sound of the tarantella. So they call the musicians, usually violinists or a person that sings and play some sort of percussion, usually tambourine, and they dance until they collapse on the floor and it's done for today. I mean, it's a lot more complex than that. Every part of Southern Italy has their own tradition of tarantella. This is mostly associated to like the part of the coast of Greece, which is the Apulia region, the south part of the Apulia region called Salento. But there's other traditional tarantellas, like not as morbid as this one. Sometimes it's just it's a way for people to get together and dance and have a good time. The lyrics are sometimes they have meaning, sometimes they have no meanings. It's music of the people, so you know they were not educated. It's not poems, you know. It's not the music of Iran or the Ottoman music. It's the music of the people. So lyrics can be very crude. Sometimes a way to revolt against the people above them, make fun of the people in the audience or some other person that's not there present, or to declare the love to somebody who's in the audience or not. So that's a long one.
One more?
Yes, I noticed on the harp on the top you were maneuvering that. What is that? Is that to change the tone? Or?
Yes, that's exactly what it does. The harp is sort of like any harp, even the big pedal harps. It's sort of like a piano that's missing all of the black keys. So if I need a sharp or a flat, so to speak, I need to shorten the string slightly. So that's a C sharp. And then if I want the C back, I have to put it back down. So in another song coming up, you'll see a little bit of lever gymnastics going on.
She plays the tarantella on the harp. She dances on
that. We're gonna take you to Bulgaria now. This is a song I learned.
How's the balance of the instrument? Okay, you can hear everybody? Okay? Nobody's too loud? Good. Okay. Sorry, you should have asked her before.
Yeah. So, this is a song that is. I initially learned it from an album of songs about spinning and weaving. At one point in my life, I worked on a farm up in Maine and I learned how to spin yarn. And I learned this up there. And this particular song is from Bulgaria. It's about a woman who is newly engaged and she stays up late at night making, spinning and weaving new gifts for her new in-laws-to-be. And I have a friend from Bulgaria who helped me with the pronunciation, and she said it's old Bulgarian. So I'm not sure how old this song is, but it's old enough that the language has since changed, and it's old enough that it was normal to be staying up late at night spinning and weaving.
Thank you.
So the next tune is an original composition by one of my greatest friends here in Boston. His name is Roberto Cassan. He passed tragically in 2016 in Italy. And we used to have a group together called Gran Fatilla. We were relatively successful. And the group obviously just finished because he passed, and none of us felt the need to continue that route. So this is a song that he wrote for his daughter when she was born, and it's written in the style of Argentinian tango called Milonga. Milonga is a place where people get together and dance tango, but it's also called Milonga, a very style of sensual, slow music that come from Argentina. So his daughter is called Lucia, so we call this tune Milonga para Lucia, Milonga for Lucia. And we give this to Roberto, wherever he is.
So we've been playing a lot of traditional music, but one of the things we like to do as a group especially is think outside the box. So now we're going to play some Taylor Swift. This is called Invisible String. So we're gonna do. We're just figuring out how much time we have left and how many more songs we can do. I think we have time to do a few more of those like that. This one is "Stay" by Justin Bieber. It's always fun to kind of take a song apart. You can. Oh yes, you have a question.
Your music is so fun. Where else can we hear your music, and do you perform at other places in the
area? We play for lots of weddings, so it's like you can't hear our music there. But we do have a mailing list. I don't know if we have anything as a group coming up. So sign up for a mailing list, and you can find us online, Boston Harpbeat at. Whatever it is, .com. I was going to say the email address. But yeah, bostonheartbeat.com. And you can sign up for our mailing list, and we will let you know when we're going to play again. So, as I was going to say, it's always kind of fun to take a song apart and kind of differentiate the melody and the harmony and then how to redo it on our instruments. So we're going to do... the next song we're going to play is called Señorita. By Camila Cabello, I forget. for the harp part of this, I kind of tried to incorporate some of the traditional South American harp techniques. I've actually had a chance to go to South America before the pandemic to learn more about the South American harp tradition. So I kind of incorporated that into this song. Thank you. one more cover for you, and then something else after that. This is, I think, actually one of our favorite songs. This is Fast Car by Tracy Chapman. And it's funny, because when I first heard this song, I was in a car listening to the radio, and they didn't say the name of this song. And I kind of remembered the melody in my head, and I asked people for several years after that, do you know this song that's called, goes like this, da 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 da. And somebody actually figured it out from what I was singing. Yes, they are. Genius. So this last song is one that I wrote just making sure it's set up the right way. We're gonna get groovy. So I was kind of playing around with a traditional Irish reel, and then I kind of added some funky chords and some syncopated rhythms, so I decided to call it Groovy Reel. For coming. If you want to sign up for our mailing list, it's over there, in that kind of pole there. And if anyone wants to come up and see our instruments or talk to us as we're packing up, you're welcome to do so. Have a wonderful afternoon.
ACMi productions are only made possible with your support. Visit patreon.com/ACMI to learn how you can help.